Thinking about Ignatian spirituality and the exercises of St. Ignatius, one thing comes to mind, the concept of the more, modus, and thinking about how can we better, using all of the tools that we have access to here in the 21st century, how can we more effectively and meaningfully enrich the lives of our students?
St. Ignatius of Loyola talks about how we need to meet people where they are. And I believe by going to a one-to-one iPad program at Loyola Academy, we are meeting our ramblers where they are at as students. And I believe we can do this while maintaining our sense of educational excellence and being one of the top leading Jesuit schools.
These students create and develop and work with them on an individual basis in using the technology of the iPad, whereas previously you're able to do that, but now with the iPad you can do it in a more systematic, efficient manner to really get in touch with each individual kid in a better way.
I believe that students are going to need to become digital learners. So almost on a very baseline of college preparation, we have to be introducing them to this tool so that they can succeed at the next level. Students are well raised, the parents care. I think everybody is in place to make this an appropriate introduction to the into the community.
For calculus, we use iTunes U, and Mr. Minolti can post our assignments for the days and also worksheets. And what we can do is we can pull up the worksheets on something called Good Notes, and we can take notes in class using a stylus, and we can bring up the worksheets and write on the worksheets as well.
I've been around a few years, so as a teacher who's kind of set in his ways a little bit, I saw it as a neat opportunity to try something new. They seem to be almost more organized because of it. But at the same time, it is a distraction, I think, for some kids. I also think teachers are going to have to sit down and kind of rethink how they go about preparing their classes.
iTunes U has helped me tremendously in my history class, especially what have you with organization. Every day, my teacher posts homework, and then any materials that I need during the class, I can bring up on iTunes U, searching for it. In this list, it acts as a tremendous supplement to the book, and when I have it, I'm able to come more prepared to class and have a better background knowledge on our subjects.
For me, the biggest impact has been transition to a flipped classroom, that I create videos at school that I then post online, and the students use their iPad to watch those videos. So their homework is to go home and watch the videos, and then when they come into class, we are using that time to solve problems, to do lab, to be doing science, as opposed to having the students listen to my lectures then. So they've already listened to the lectures in the video, and they come in, we're actually involved in solving out the science that I want them to be doing.
We have our textbook online, so you can use this all the time, and you can have the answers right next to you. And go to a new page and see the answers, so check your homework. Use iTunes U, which has all our assignments up here, as well as our lectures. And we also can message each other about labs or about homework or about any questions that you have.
So far this year, my students have been using the iPads because they can access their textbook through an app, and I like that because then it's one less book that they have to bring to class. They can easily practice activities because they have them right at their fingertips. I also like that they have access to other resources, not just their textbook, that if there's a word that they don't know and it's not in their book, they have a Spanish-English dictionary app. One of the things that I've liked the most about using the iPads in the class is that there has been a real sense of collaboration. students have been so willing to share what they know with their classmates and with me. Most of the stuff that I've learned how to do so far has been through suggestions from my students. And so I really am pleased to see such collaboration among students. So when I was first invited to be part of the iPad pilot program, I had really mixed feelings. I was excited to be part of something new and something, you know, that could have so much potential. But on the other hand, I'm someone who does not have an iPhone, never used an iPad, I don't have a Mac, so I was the person who didn't even know how to turn on the iPad. And so there was definitely some anxiety there, but I have to say it was very easy to learn how to use the iPad. I feel very confident with it now. I would say my class felt the same way, too. They were really excited to be part of this program, but there was, you know, some anxiety about how this would change their learning and if they would know what to do. But looking at my class now compared to what it was just, you know, 2 months ago, the comfort level is amazing. We really don't have many problems when we're using the iPad. If we do, the kids are great at helping with each other, helping me. You know, fix little glitches, see how many of the students in the class are right or wrong, and I know right on the spot whether this is something I have to go back and reteach or whether the kids have mastered it and we move on. That's one of the favorite things in my class. We recently tried Bump, which is kind of a fun thing where a student could do a problem and immediately they just bump it to my iPad and I can put their work right up on the board. So it saves us the time of having a student have to redraw their diagram and write up their work, but then they've got all their work and they can go up there and explain it. And so we really are finding a lot of new exciting ways to bring the iPad into our math class. You know, and I have to say, I was a little cautious and hesitant at first, but as we use it more and more, I've become more and more optimistic.
I have just been shocked at how much I've been using it. My biggest concern was that I do have a big curriculum to follow that involves drawing with pencils and painting with brushes and all kinds of things that I knew I had to get through, so I wasn't sure exactly how I was going to use it. But number one, everyone in the class has a camera that they can use anytime they want. They also have a computer on them, so when I go around to them and to some of the students and say, "Oh my gosh, your work looks like Richard Diebenkorn's work. Why don't you take a look at him?" There's this immediate tool where they can get on and see another artist's work. So it's been just an incredible tool in the classroom. We use it for documenting work, we use it for researching other artists, we use it for taking pictures of a still life in the classroom and then going home and finishing the painting. So I've been thrilled with it, and I'm looking forward to hopefully using it in all the classes.
We researched artists,
took notes in Evernote,
took screenshots,
and then we put in the Bump app.
We bumped our notes.
Now we have 20 different notes
in our iPad.
I think if we're very, very serious about this, and I think if we learn from our mistakes by working with a nice controlled environment to start with, it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful, you know, opportunity for us. How can Loyola not be on the cutting edge of technology if we are going to be the top, or if we are the top, Jesuit school?
Anything could happen. Anything could happen.